as I lay me down. Heaven, hear me now. I'm lost without a cause. After giving it my all, winter storms have come and darkened my sun. After all that I've been through, who on earth can I turn to? I look to you. I look to you. After all my strength is gone, in you I can be strong. I look to you. Searching for that open door. And every road that I've taken led to my regret. And I don't know if I'm gonna make it. Nothing to do but lift my head. I look to you. I look to you.
Bye. to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Andrew. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Andrew. Happy birthday to you. May the Lord bless you. May the good Lord bless you. May the good Lord bless you.
It is an honor and delight to be among good people, wonderful people, and friends of the Honorable Andrew Old-Sanders that we are here to honor and to celebrate with tonight. Now, whether or not you know everybody in the room, that's not the important thing. The important thing that all of us that are in the room are here specifically for the celebration of this honorable gentleman here. That said, we're all friends. So if you didn't like me, may as well just start liking me, because we're all friends of a very special man. Amen. And by the time the night is through, let's all try to know each other as best as we can. And let's allow the awesome friendship and love that have flown from this gentleman to us, let it flow from us around the room. Well, this is the human rights function that you're at.
Right here.
Now that you're aware that you're going to be singing at the human rights function, we have that on the program somewhere down there. So later on we'll have you doing just that. But let me take the opportunity to just welcome everybody that's here. And I want to especially congratulate my good friend Andrew, and to say how glad I am here with my wife to join with all the others to celebrate you on this day. Last year, May, I celebrated my 50th birthday, and he was there. Yes. And we're here again. Last year, you celebrated your 50th. Now, that's it. That's it. My mind goes to scripture that says, "Behold, how good and how pleasant it is." It is a pleasant thing to be here and to be a part of this occasion this afternoon. In this year of your Jubilee, we pray that the blessing of the Lord will abound upon you richly. As from a personal standpoint, after my 50th birthday last year May, I entered into a special release from God that I've never had a year so awesome in my entire life. And I've seen the hand of God upon my life in some very, very special ways. That said, I believe that as you, Andrew, enter into this, your 50th year, which officially is tomorrow, I petition the God of heaven that he will pour out upon you abounding blessings that will take your life so further in him and in dimensions that you have never been before. And somebody say amen.
Amen.
So I'm going to be inviting to come at this time Dr. Freddie Thompson. He's going to be doing the opening prayer, and he's also going to be blessing the meal. Please, let's put our hands together and welcome Reverend Freddie Thompson.
Righteous, loving God, the giver of all good gifts, for all good gifts around us are sent from heaven above. We lift up your name at this time, and we are so appreciative of your goodness, of your mercy, and of your love. We thank you, God, for this occasion to which we are gathered, where our friend, our brother, your son, Andrew, is here to celebrate 50 years, oh God, of life. When you breathed into him and he became a living soul. We thank you for him tonight, O God, and for all the blessings that you have bestowed upon him. We thank you for the way you have led his life, even to allow him to become conscious of the need for a Savior, and to do so at a tender age. Lord, we thank you. And Lord God, even as he moves forward into another year and another segment of his life, we pray that the developments that are to come will be ordered by you. We ask God for your Holy Spirit to dominate his life. We pray that you will choose for him and that you will direct him in the way you would have him to go. Lord, we bring his family before you at this time. And we pray that you will prosper the works of his hands, so that, Lord God, he'll be able to adequately meet the needs of his household. Oh God, we pray for prosperity. We pray for good health. We pray, God, for a good relationship. Hallelujah. On the job, in the home, in ministry. Wherever, O God, he answers the call, we pray that you will be there to give guidance and direction. We thank you, God, for everyone gathered here to share with Andrew. Help, Lord, that the thoughts that will be expressed here tonight would serve, Lord God, as inspirational thoughts to him, even as he goes forward. So we ask now that you will sanctify this occasion. Blessed Lord God, as you bless the wedding at Cana of Galilee, may you turn water into wine. We pray that you will turn every disappointment into a blessing. Anything that would impact negatively upon this occasion and upon your son, we ask that you will turn it around for good. Oh God, let your Holy Spirit have the reigns. And God, this meal that is set before, give us grateful hearts. And we ask that you will sanctify it, that you will bless it, Lord. Cause it to be of nourishment to our bodies, and that in turn we will use our bodies to your service. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Dr. Freddy, and everybody say amen.
And this evening we're actually recognizing that he has entered into a new phase of his life, and it is actually called certified gold. Amen. Now it is said that when records have sold over 500,000 copies, then it is certified gold. Now obviously our friend has hit a new milestone in his life, and he's now certified. He's certified to walk in the company of Bishop Everton, who has been certified for some time, and Bishop Robert Stewart, who has been certified, and Elder Freddie Thompson, who has been certified. All the certified people inside here, could I see your hands? All the certified people?
I'm certified.
Amen. So we're celebrating with Andrew this afternoon as the new certified individual who is in this room. So everybody, if you would now make your way to the table to be served.
Time will bring, or in peace our hearts will sing. all people. It's in the dream that you had so long ago that lives in all of the hearts of people. Our hearts tell us
Happy birthday, Mammoth. When I was contacted by your lovely wife to participate in this 50th birthday celebration, I must say I felt honored because I've never met the lady. So her efforts were definitely as a result of your report on who I am and what I mean to you. And that is an honor, sir. You know, Andrew, I've known you for over 30 years. And the math alone should have prepared me for this celebration. But somehow, I just can't appreciate Andrew Seibert being 50. I guess if Andrew is 50, then how old am I? Well, Andrew, we have embarked on parallel paths. We are both brothers in Christ. We are both sons of the Hermitage. We are both entrepreneurs of some sort. Based on what I've been seeing, you have definitely surpassed me in that area. But I guess that might be where the similarity ends, because my voice does not compare. Anyway, Andrew, I wish you God's richest blessing, and I hope from here onwards I will be able to participate more in the over 50 Andrew Simon.
Happy birthday!
Happy 50th birthday from the Witten family. From, can you even see me?
Yes. Oh my God!
Surprise! From the Witten family of the United States of America, the land of the free, the home of the brave.
You're blocking everybody.
Today is 68 degrees, and then tomorrow we're having a major snowstorm. So, I don't even know why I told you that. Well, happy birthday! And
we love you, Andrew. I love you so much. I love all the memories we've had over the years. I love that you're my big brother. I love that you married the most beautiful woman in the world, Charlie, besides your sister, me. And I love baby Nate. And I miss you guys. Wish we could be there with you. Can't wait for us to go golfing. And
sister,
stop it. I'm bowling. And my favorite, what's the name of the game again? With Cheryl Lee.
Catchphrase.
Cheryl Lee, you're the best. But anyway, we want to go out with this. Happy birthday to you. Say it.
Happy birthday to you.
She hit me. Happy birthday.
Cheryl Lee and Steph. We couldn't own four tickets, but it's all right.
That's
all right. Everyone wish you a happy birthday, Josiah. Over here. Come on.
Yeah. We could have drive. We could have drive to Josiah too.
But we didn't.
Oh, Florida?
It was Florida. I was just there.
It's Jamaica.
But we're flying from Florida. It's cheaper. It's a long story.
I have no idea what he's talking about. But we just want to wish you a happy birthday.
You remember her, right? The big hair girl, my daughter.
Yeah. Josiah, say happy birthday.
Yeah, everyone is not here.
You know, and 50 Andrew, big 50, you old man.
Yeah, but guess who's next?
You old boy. you just come to it, you got a pretty like me. Yeah.
Happy birthday.
May many blessings. The Lord shine upon you and give you 50 times 50
Amen.
More.
Amen.
Now we have to
not
go
me,
eat.
Not me, not 50 right. times more. No, all right, I can stay at this 50.
Okay.
All right.
This 50, please, I think he's got the point.
I love you, Andrew.
I can't believe you made it this far. still remember you running up the hill in Harborview. But
long legs, long
happy birthday.
Legs running up the hill.
Happy birthday, God bless you.
Oh,
love you, love you.
Happy birthday! I'm back! You guys can't get rid of me! I'm the baby!
You were not there when he was running up the hill.
It doesn't matter! Happy birthday, bro.
Andrew, it's your 50th birthday. Congratulations. I pray that you have many more blessings in the future. And we all love you.
Happy birthday.
I was actually having fun watching those videos. And not just that I'm having fun watching those videos, but watching Andrew up there, you know, like him getting excited with everything that's going on. So that was interactive. I hope the video man caught you doing all them acrobatics at the tapes going on. All right, folks, we're gonna be having some live toasts now. So I'm gonna be asking Dr. Pauline Mullins to come, and she's gonna give our first toast. Let's put our hands together for her as she comes to toast. Brother.
Mr. Marcel Ceremonies, or Honoree, Brother Andrew, other distinguished guests at the head table, distinguished guests in the audience, everyone, good evening. It was indeed a pleasure to have been asked, Andrew, to give a toast on your behalf. Immediately I started thinking and going down memory lane, looking at the pictures tonight brought back so many vivid memories. I knew Andrew from he was about 4 years old. And I had the opportunity, well, I'm not sure if I went to Pentecostal Gospel Temple and saw his mother, she came in after, but I've been there. It would have been when you were four. But as a young person, and I had the opportunity of teaching Andrew in Sunday school twice, when he was younger, and then when he got to 16, between that 16 and 21 years old. During that time, I watched him, and there were so many beautiful qualities that came from Andrew. The one that stands out in my mind more than anything else is how respectful a person Andrew is. He's well-mannered. I had to tell his mother on one occasion that she really did an excellent job with Andrew, the type of person I know him to be. Andrew is a ladies' gentleman, has always been, and I don't think anything has changed. Andrew's quick to run to open the car door. He's making sure you're sitting comfortable before he drives off. He's making sure. Andrew have a way with words that can really let you know that his compliments is from the heart, but also it's gracious. I find Andrew to be very kind and caring, and I want to close with this. Some years ago, being a teacher at Kingston High School, I don't know if Andrew remember that, it has never left my mind. There was a student who was struggling with her exam fees. I put what I could, but I couldn't do it all. And I said, Lord, you have to show me somebody when I go to church today who I can ask, and they will understand and they will help this child. And I approached Andrew, and I explained the situation. And without any delay, I got the money, and the student was able to sit our exams. That's the kind of person we celebrate tonight. A loving, caring, warm, respectful, and no doubt, endearing individual. Andrew, you know I love you. And I thank you for the opportunity you have given me to share in your life all these many years. The good times, the rough times, the prayerful times. I am grateful that God has allowed our path to cross. And tonight, I celebrate you. Live long, Andrew. Live healthy. Live well. But above all, stay in the grace of the Almighty God. God bless you.
Thank you, Dr. Mullins. I noticed you didn't need any notes at all. It was all there in the heart. Amen. You all right, Brother Andrew?
I need a drink.
well, drink because the man who is coming to do the next toast is no stranger to you either. And a longtime family friend. So I'm going to be inviting to come at this time, Elder McCormick. Please put your hands together and make him welcome everybody.
Mr. Master of Ceremony, honored guests, Mr. Reed Bishop as well, and our dear pastor and his wife, and to all of you guests that are here this evening on this very auspicious occasion, in the sense that Andrew had to be the one who gets some people here. But I believe his wife was rather cunning in not letting Andrew know too much about what was being planned. And it's a good thing that one has a good heart, because occasions like these, persons who are scared and frightened out of their wits drop dead. Andrew was beside himself when he opened the door to see that there was a collection of his special friends gathered to share with Andrew his 50th birthday. I have a feeling Andrew's going to have to ask for a recount, you know. How come? How come you reach 50?
I have no idea.
I remember the days when Andrew used to go to Wilbert Stewart Basic School. I had the privilege of living next door to him, in so much that I know his mom, his sister, and his other brother. And surely they were a happy bunch. Indeed, happiness is one of those things that keep Andrew young. Because with Andrew, there is always laughter. I don't think Andrew can smile. It has to turn out to a laughter. So infectious it is that you've got to laugh too. And whenever he comes by you, he is so respectful, in the sense that I don't think it is something he just practiced. I think it is something he learned, he was groomed, and he did well in showing regard for everyone he meets. And in this respect, I feel that Andrew is going to be forever young. Because the joy in his heart that he received of the Lord and the opportunity he had in getting filled with the Holy Ghost made him truly a happy person. And you know, if nothing else, we ought to know that what keeps us young. Well, we have a song in Sunday school, don't we? Smile a while, give your face a rest, ask Andrew about that. He knows exactly how to give his face a rest. May God richly bless you, Andrew. And may the 50 years, they said, well, talk about certified and, you know. I'm not saying you must live for 50 more years, but as long as you live with the Lord and stay with him, you shall surely experience many more happy years. God bless you, in Jesus' name.
Thank you, Elder Mac. I think it is worth noting possibly the most important guest that is in this room tonight, the former pastor of Andrew, the Honorable Bishop Carmen Stewart, and a woman who ran the race and knew when the time came to hand over the baton, and she did that graciously and still stands in the kingdom of God as a light and as a wonderful example to all of us. Please, let's put our hands together in honor of the Honorable Bishop Carmen Stewart Everybody. Amen. I know Andrew must feel very good and special to see Bishop here tonight. There's one thing I wanted of Bishop, you know, and it never happened. And it is, you know, it's amazing how the things we have, we take for granted. And sometimes we take the things we have for granted because it is there most of the time. And then there are others who would have wanted just a little bit of what you've had. But there's something I've always wanted, and it's for Bishop Carmen Stewart to preach at my church. I've always wanted her to preach at my church. You know, I've had Dr. Edlin, her sister, so many times, over and over, and she is just a blessing to us. But I've always wanted, and every time something make it not happen. You know, so just to see her here tonight was such a blessing. I had to go over and give her a little kiss and tell her a little bit of how much I love her. Love you, Bishop, and I give you honor tonight. Amen. Please, everybody, put your hands together for Bishop Carmen Stewart. Woman who has nurtured and pastored Andrew for many, many years. I remember back then years, you know, going to 111. And I was just thinking about it earlier. That when you look at the choir, if you miss everybody else at the choir, you can't miss Andrew Teat. You just want to look up there at the choir. And Andrew's singing, but he's laughing. I don't know how he does it. He sings and he laughs, and his teeth is just always out there. Oh Lord, Andrew, you're a special guy, and believe me, that smile is a contagious smile, and it's a smile that all of us in this room, I believe, can connect with to this very day. We love you, man. Everybody, please put your hands together for the man that has reached certified gold. I'm going to be asking to come at this time the Honorable Pastor who succeeded the Honorable Bishop Carmen Stewart to come, and he's going to be proposing his toast at this time. Please join with me in welcoming Pastor Robert Stewart, everybody.
You would mind. That's the only Bible I must have. Stick to the bill. It has 4 wheels.
Thank you, sir.
On the right, rather than mine.
In the
mind. Our master and servant is. Pastor. Amen. I agree with you. Thank you so much. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, greetings. I purposely did not prepare a toast. There is one word that I remember. Every time I remember that word, I remember Andrew. The first time I heard that word was Andrew. Discombobulated. This is exactly what I am writing. I am discombobulated. But ladies and gentlemen, Andrew calls me dad. Therefore, my son was born when I was in fourth form in high school. And I thank God in those days I did wonderful in school. I came to Winona Grove Church in 1970. That means Andrew would have been 3. I can't recall exactly when we met, but I recall the uniform, the Camperdown High School uniform. I understand he went to Wilbur Street Basic School. That means I would have been at Wilbur Street. But this...
No, the green blue VW.
The green one.
Well, at 50, you know, you mix up colors.
You are only 50, you'll be 50 tomorrow, so you'll understand after tomorrow. So enjoy the rest of tonight.
Yes, yeah, last 50. Night.
After 50, you have the car key in your hand and you're asking for it.
And the glasses on your face.
So remember that. But Andrew came to Windward Road Church as a young man, grew up there. And Sister Dawn says something about Andrew that is so true. He is so manly. I can't recall in my entire life of Andrew seeing him or hearing him be rude to anyone. Even if you hurt him, you see the hurt in his face. Or he would just hang his head and walk away. And I always admire that of him. He's such a gentleman. My table says faithful. And as a chorister at Windward Road Church, Andrew has been so faithful. I think he can sing. I remember in the early days he could make up his mind whether it's Ray Charles or whoever. But a blind fellow named Steve Wonder. So Sister Barbara had a hard time with him. He was a spoil the song. And I remember the night when the bus, it was at the National Arena. Did that solo piece, and the young man held that note, yes. And we all felt proud.
Amen, amen.
And he never looked back.
Amen, amen. Never looked back.
Andrew, I speak on behalf of our bishop. I speak on behalf of my wife, your mom, and the entire Pentecostal Gospel Temple family. You serve us well. You have left a mark. There are many persons who can call you friend. You would go the last mile to accomplish a task for your friends. You call me dad, but I call you son and a friend. And I'm here tonight because I want you to know that I really love you. When I got the email from your wife that you were 50, ask her what I said. I said, surely the boy are really 50. In my mind, you'd never reach 50. Somewhere you'd stop somewhere.
In my mind too.
So it was really a challenge to think of you being 50, but you are really 50. You know, I came early. And when they say you should never enter the wedding without your wedding garment, when I went home this evening, we had no light. And I had two cell phones on to get light. And so when I was dressed and came down here and I saw Elliot Thompson, who I was looking for, the pastor, half a hour ago. So I went back home, and when I came to the gate, I saw this van. Van was coming this way, I was coming this way. But the size of your head in the van looked so big that I wasn't certain it was you. But then when you're about to push out your head to tell the security to let you, and realize it was you, I said, my God, what am I going to do? So I thought he saw me, but he drove in, he reversed, he parked, I passed him, and I said, I'm not coming out of a vehicle. So we were just behind each other, and I'm glad it was a surprise. But Andrew, may God bless you. I want to let you know that the entire Pentecostal Gospel Temple family, we still cherish the members of you, we talk about you, and we will never ever forget you. And what we love is you don't forget us. So on my 7th anniversary on Sunday, I hope to see you. Not hope, I know I'll see you. So I just remind you, 7th is on Sunday. So on behalf of my wife, our bishop, and all, you see our Elder Thompson here, Elder McCormick, a number of Portmore folks and others, we're here, Andrew, to celebrate with you. One warning I'm going to give to you. In cricket, when you get to 50, you look to the umpire and say, and he knows what that means, so you're taking guard again. So you want to live longer and enjoy life, you have to stop hooking now. Don't hook after anything outside the off stump. Just play straight down the line. God bless you.
If you're gonna bring him Andrew on his 7th anniversary, but maybe you could give him your son's car.
I'll find him up for that.
yes, awesome. I enjoy just listening to the different toasts. I like that part that when you reach 50 you go back and you take a God. That's I like that. That's a good one. Okay, I'm gonna ask Rose Thompson to come, another family friend. Please put your hands together and welcome Sister Rose.
I like to read what I say because it makes me not to say too much and it keeps me focused on what I need to say. So, Mr. Master of Ceremonies, the organizer and orchestrator of this illustrious event, Lady Sherilee Simons, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, our celebrant, the one and only indomitably cheerful Andrew Simons. This is indeed an auspicious and historic moment, which will never happen again, as the celebrant will never be 50 years old more than once in a lifetime. I tried to defer this task by having someone else do justice to a toast for Andrew, but I was not let off the hook by Mrs. Simons. It is therefore with delight that I say a few words to someone as special as Brother Andrew has grown to become to so many of us present here tonight. I've had the opportunity of observing Andrew as a young boy. Skinny, lanky, big head and forehead, big eyes, wide smile with plenty of teeth. Yes. And he grew up to be the tall, dark, handsome, debonair, charmer, stop your dead in your tracks, grown man. Brother Andrew was what you call well-raised, as you have heard other persons have said in this room about his behavior, his respectfulness, his faithfulness. He was well-raised. He grew up with a principled mother who saw to his early Christian exposure to Sunday school and church. Soon, Andrew became known for his great singing voice, among other leadership skills he possessed. Soloist, music arranger, choir director, and composer. Andrew served well in all the capacities he was challenged to undertake, lead, and direct. Many things can be admired about Brother Andrew. He was devoted to his mother. He was faithful to given tasks. He was selective about his friendships and surrounded himself with the right crew, friends who inspired and motivated his growth and development, friends who are successes themselves. Stephen Davis, Donovan Smith, Dean Smith, Carl Anderson, to name a few. Andrew kept his integrity while studying abroad and made us proud at PGT by his academic accomplishments. Yes, he was a head turner and had a following. I recall inviting him to perform at a function for events planning at the Knutsford Court Hotel. And after Andrew's performance, I had quite a few of the ladies rushing to me to check out his availability and to express their availability. I guess being handsome and debonair and with lyrics, he did have challenges with the ladies. He and I had a run-in once. I won't say. A long time ago, about one of these ladies. However, not all fitted the bill. You see, the lady of choice had to fit a certain criteria. She had to be attractive, slim, tall, with a mod-like figure. That's where the lady Sherry Lee triumphed. Yes, she won first place in Andrew's heart. I could spend time talking about Andrew's love for God and his dedication, of his generous, loving, and caring spirit, of his humility and gentlemanlikeness, his courtesy and mannerable disposition. But I will leave some of the accolades for another auspicious occasion. Brother Andrew, welcome to the Senior Citizens Department. There are benefits at the bank and at the ATM, among other things. God bless you with health, strength, and long life. We love you, Brother Freddie and me.
Things that we never know, we're getting to know them tonight. Love it, love it, love it. All right, everybody, if you notice, your table was given a name. I'm going to ask for a volunteer from each table. If you could just tell us, stand and tell us something about Andrew that is in reference to that name that's on your table. Okay, so let's move it. Loving, caring.
Loving, caring. Good night, everyone.
Good
Happy
night.
Birthday, Andrew. Smile 50 smiles. I know. Well, we have loving, caring. And I think everybody at this table had some time
have experienced, Andrew give you a big hug and a big kiss on your cheek. Nobody experienced that. And Dean and Kirk can testify also. Yes, you can. Yes, you can. Yes, you can. But absolutely, we know Andrew is very loving and very caring. He will not see you on the road how late and not take you home, asking you if you're okay, trying, you know, tap in and see if everything is okay. I'm trying to gauge the temperature here. Can you identify with that? Yes, just to make sure that you are okay. He'll go that extra mile just to make sure that you're comfortable. And I ask you to continue being, I know a lot of your energy now, your love here has been transferred to your beautiful family with the beautiful Charity and your lovely, lovely son. But we ask you to come through your senior years to be as loving and caring as possible. And it will keep you looking young, okay? When you're mean and not tender-hearted, you look older. So you have to stay really kind and loving and caring, and it will keep you younger.
Please put your hands together for loving and caring. Okay, we come now to respectful. On that note, I have good news for love and caring table. He has reserved loving and caring, even though he is giving a lot to his family. So he'll still take you home. If I think only one, you're not going to see, he's not going to land any kiss on any of the men now. Not going to land any kiss on any of the men.
It's really a pleasure tonight to say something with respect to Andrew. Many years ago. But let me tell you what happened this last week, or was it this week? When you're over 50 sometimes, it's difficult to remember.
We understand.
Yeah, okay. But somebody said to me that, I didn't know that Andrew was 50. And I said, I couldn't understand why this young man takes so long to reach 50. You know, because I was dying for other people to reach 50, you know, so that I didn't look so old. But nevertheless, you know, I remember the days Andrew on campus. We have campus ministry. And, you know, there was this young man, very respectful young man, that would join us. I would tell you, I really joined them because you were before me, right? And yet you are just 50. We really admired Andrew. He was such a respectful person. And even to PGT and our association, and I hear your discourse with others, yes sir, yes ma'am, and so on. You know, to be honest with you, it wasn't something that I practiced, you know, and so it was, extremely outstanding and conspicuous when, you know, somebody that shows that level of respect for others. And Andrew, I really appreciate you. I love to hear Andrew sing. This is one, and there's a song that he does, you know, what was it about? Seeing Abraham who would go to heaven. I love that song, and
you
always enjoy your singing, and I just encourage you that you will continue to be respectful, and you'll continue to serve God in your singing and in your other. Okay, so God bless you, and it's so good to see that you have now reached the 50 club, and I hope we can learn some things from you that are not present in the club. God bless you. Okay. On behalf of this table, we wish for you a
successful senior citizen years. You know, God bless you in Jesus' name.
Please put your hands together for the table respected. I was wondering though, is it that you wanted to say to him that you wish for him more children? Because I see you going there, but it's like, you know.
We wish for the desire of his heart.
We go. So we will exclude those two. Okay. I'll go to the Pentagon and come back to people.
To our wonderful guests gathered here this evening. Andrew,
yes, sir.
Happy birthday, boss.
Thank you, sir.
The pendulum, I don't know if it's by coincidence, because really, I'm in the capacity of a musician tonight, so I'm really not supposed to be at this table. I was hoping, depending on somebody else, to be dependable enough to speak to Andrew's dependability. But it fell on me. Andrew, it's a real pleasure. We go way back. Way back. We've seen some dark waters. But Andrew is quite dependable. I mean, this is a word that all of us can relate to when you think of Andrew, and many of you have said it before. He is quite a dependable guy. I know Andrew is a very articulate guy, and he's a smart guy. And if there's anything that he struggles with, I think he struggles with the word no, a simple word as no. He struggles with that, and you hardly know how to say no. And when I think of the pen, a few months ago, about 9 months ago, my car broke down. And it broke down at a very awkward time. It was coming up to convention and I needed to be at rehearsals. And, you know, one car in the family and it's just my hand and my feet. And Andrew stepped in and allowed me to just take his car. He was so different. I had a choice as to which of his cars I drove. That's how dependable Andrew is. And during that period, I was not without a car because of Andrew's dependability. And so tonight, I just want to celebrate with you, and before I forget, even though I'm not over on that side yet, but on behalf of this table, we want to say, we celebrate you tonight, and we are so happy for you, and you know, when you have a chance, you'll tell me how it feels to be over on that side. But since I have a few more years before I get there, enjoy the ride, brother. And big up to you and big up to your family. And, you know, I see Nate looking a little lonely up there. So I'm just saying, come on, Berta. You guys get busy. It's not too late, all right? After all, age is just a number, right?
That's right.
All right. So big up to you and we wish you all the best. And many more years, 50 times, 50 more. Bless you.
We come to the faithful table.
Greetings, everyone. Oh, it's such a pleasure to be here tonight. And it had to be love that brought me out tonight. It's love for Andrew, yes, because you know, we had some other pressing things to do. But just to let Andrew know tonight that we really love him. And I was just thinking, well, we tried to abscond the being able to give a toast tonight, but I decided to stand because I remember I've been in the church now for maybe over 35 years, and I can't remember in our visitations to 111 not seeing Andrew. on the choir. I remember him as a young person. I remember him. I've been just tracking his life, and I know he's someone who I can agree with his kindness and his respect. He's now with us at the Emmanuel Apostolic Church, and he has been faithful family man. He's an elder Andrew Simons, and you know, for that we honor him. He has really been faithful. He helps with the choir, trains the choir, and you know, for that we are grateful. And so Andrew, we just want to tell you that we love you. We honor you tonight. You're in the senior citizen group, but life begins at 50. Tell them, life begins at 50. God bless you.
On the note that life begins at 50, and he's still got one more night left, he's dead until tomorrow. All right, great. We're going to turn to some more greetings. Bye, Vicky.
Uncle Andrew, it's Sasha
and Matt,
and we are saying happy 50th birthday all the way from Buffalo, New York. Happy birthday. We are freezing up here, so we're hoping that you are having a much warmer time in Jamaica, but enjoy yourself at your birthday party. You deserve it. You are my favorite uncle, but don't tell anybody I said that. Have a wonderful time. You deserve the best. And
we'll see you soon. We'll meet you soon.
Yeah, we'll see you very soon. We'll see you this summer. So party it up, shake it on down. Have a great time. Love you. Happy birthday.
Bye.
Greetings, Andrew. Just wishing you a happy birthday from myself and the family all the way over here in England. So whatever you do, enjoy, have fun, eat well, and I'm sure we'll catch up soon. Yeah. All right, take care for now. Bye-bye.
This is Errol from Toronto, Canada. Want to wish my brother Andrew a very special 50th birthday. May God continue to bless every day of your life with health, happiness, love, and prosperity. You have reached a milestone in your life, bro, so enjoy it to the max. Love you lots. See you soon.
What's up, Unc? It's the big one, the big 5-0. Man, happy birthday, Uncle. Hope you have a blessed one. Hope you enjoy your party. Sorry I wasn't there to enjoy it with you. But we're going to turn up, you know, for the big wedding day. So happy birthday, man. All right, love you. Peace.
Happy birthday, Uncle Andrew.
Yeah, no respect, big man. All right, go. That's it.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Andrew. Happy birthday to you.
Yes, Uncle.
Congrats. Congratulations. Half a century. I'm right behind you, though. I'm not jealous. I hope you have a great, great time. Enjoy.
Right. Enjoy the day.
Yes, Uncle. You're still young.
Love you.
Still young.
Hi, Andrew. I just want to say happy 50th birthday from my family to you. Wishing you all the best. I hope you enjoy your special day. May God bless you always. Love you lots. Bye.
Hello, Uncle. I just wanted to leave you a video just to say happy birthday. Don't mind me as I am relaxing. But anyways, just wanted to say happy birthday. I pray God will give you many, many more. It's a little hard to get everybody together as everybody lives in their separate areas and what have you. But I just want to say, you know, I wish you a happy birthday. May God continue to bless you and keep you. May His face continue to shine upon you. And I just pray for prosperity, financial blessings, and everything that God has to give for you. So I hope to see you soon, as we'll probably see you in September for Nkomo's wedding. But I just want to wish you a happy birthday. Have a great, 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 great day. And you are not old. You are very, 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 very young. So have a great day, okay?
Hey, God bless. Andrew. Love you. He's from Canada. Happy birthday. Hope you're having a wonderful time celebrating this great milestone with your family and friends. Hope God continues to bless you and your family. And I hope you live to see many more.
Andrew, big up on your special day. I hope today is filled with happiness, joy, and excitement. Wish we were there drinking a nice cold dash, but unfortunately we are here in Canada and it's minus 10. In any event, I hope today is a great day and you enjoy it with your friends and family. And again, wish we were there. All the best.
Happy birthday, Andrew.
Hi, I'm Glenn.
And I'm Sean. And we're the Gales, coming to you from our ranch in Southwest Ranches, Florida.
Andrew, just want to wish you a happy birthday. 50 is an awesome number. Typically comes with a sports car, so I know your wife is working on it. Sorry I can't be there in Jamaica to enjoy this with you, but have a happy, happy birthday.
Andrew, I just want to let you know, you don't look a day over 30. Have fun, enjoy this big birthday, and Godspeed.
I was actually having fun watching those videos, and not just that I'm having fun watching those videos, but watching Andrew up there. I think the video man had you covered, so Shirley, have a lot of laughter. All right, man called Dean Smith. That go way back when. Listen, Dean. I don't want you to come up here with the formal thing, you know, because the formal people have, for the most part, gone. I want you to go way back and tell me where that was.
Yes, Dean. Good night, everyone. Best of all, honored attendees. A very good night to you all. But I can't do formal. First of all, I don't dress the part. Second of all, I would not miss this for the world. And Andrew, you know, well, based on what I've been saying so far, I can say from my own experience that 50 isn't even 40, right? That's the first thing. Second thing is, who'd have thunk? I know that's one of your favorite
parts.
Who'd have thunk when we were in short pants marching Wilbur's to a basic school? That we'll be here talking about 50. Are you still there? No. You see, as of tomorrow, you can't come. But as of tonight, you need to respect your elders. I am your elder. I am your elder. So you need to stay in your place. The story is, folks, that Andrew, Donovan, and myself, that's January, February, and March. I'm January, Andrew is February. And Donovan in March. We're born in the same year, and our moms go, I don't know what you're doing. Don't know about that time, but there's a baby boom in Pentecostal gospel at the time. Mm-hmm. So that's the story for the three of us, and we go way back. So at University of Basic School, we were all there in short pants, having fun, and not thinking about anything that could happen anywhere down the line, something like this. Now, coming up, of course, Camperdown, everybody went there who is. Donovan went to Kingston College, I went to Excel, and Andrew went to Camperdown, but we still stayed together, still had fun. There's a choir, and person's been talking about Andrew's singing, but nobody has mentioned so far his playing on the drums, which actually came before the singing. So and he loves his drums, right? Loves it. He probably felt more than singing, but he wants to do the singing because personally, I guess, appreciate that. I don't want to tell tales out of school, but Andrew.
Go ahead.
Andrew, it's all, you see, when you are compadres, you know, he lets his hair down. We don't, when we're talking. And we have had some very deep conversations. You know, we start pondering. You know, in the teens, you're pondering
future or what the future holds, the mysteries of life and all of these wonderful things. But even then, Andrew had a kind of maturity because he was, to me, a steady rock. You know, as then, kind of lost my way in the spiritual realm, and Andrew was there. And I it was my beacon to come back, even to the Pentecostal last time. But man,
Even when
in the other department, we kind of flipped the script in the other department. So he went to UTEC, or it was cast then, first, and I followed. But after, it was him asking me for advice when he came to his master's, because I had finished by then. But he was all cool, and from Camperdown, all the different jobs he had, again, a company, Red Stripe, and we'd go back then with Red Stripe, oh gosh, and then to the Water Commission. Through all of that, he was still that steady rock. That steady rock, even when it came to all the things of life, you know, the first car. His first car was a Triumph. A Triumph in a double Weber carburetor that drank gaslight. I truly needed to get rid of that car, because that car would drain him. We would not. The yellow Triumph. Oh my, I couldn't get rid of it. Even before the Bimans was the Triumph. And then there was the Bigham, then there was the Camry, then the green one, remember the green, but the white one, I loved so much that I crashed it. Come on, the Bigham! You got the Bigham, I tell you. But that green one with the manual transmission that you used to blaze around the place, that one, he loved that one the most, even more than Red October.
And she snitched the sport.
Exactly. Kit. That one was his favorite, but I digress. Right now, his favorite is sitting over there.
Yes.
That's his favorite right now. And when it comes to affairs and our heart, we had some long talks. But you remember that time we're driving down Ellison Road, and we said this, we made this pact. We said best is for life. And regardless of what happens. And I'm so, they had no idea when Nate was born, it gave me so much joy. I can't imagine what it did for Andrew. Mm-hmm. Because it's something that we have spoken about so many times, and I know it is his pride and joy. And for him to be sitting here at his 50 with his son, yes, and his side, and his wife, just over my gosh. I don't imagine, because this is something that we have spoken about at length, and it gives me great joy even to just see him here on his 50. Again, life begins at, it's a new 40, so it's just beginning. Don't worry about it. My promise that he's going to mix up some of that great punch that the roots and stuff. So I don't know what will happen after that, but he will celebrate
what is supposed to happen.
Whatever is supposed to happen.
And, you guys make me nervous.
And don't worry, like I said, don't worry about it. There's no limit on where what can happen. But again, it is an absolute joy to be celebrating with him. Many more to you, and continue to enjoy. Best is for life. Best of luck.
Like that. Best is for life. You know, the commitment of friendship and relationship is very important to the human life. And to see that there are friends that has been around for basically all your lives. That's commendable.